eastern coast of England. On the second wave of that assault was a sergeant named Nathan Hale. The actions of that soldier have become a matter of both scrutiny and myth. What follows are the known events of his life from July 11th to July the 14th, the day he was last seen. Soldiers had no idea what they would soon be facing. The US government had sealed its borders in 1950. Radio waves and newspapers became state property. Only the highest levels of their government knew the truth. The operation was an exchange. The Americans were bringing supplies and tanks into York. We were giving them our one secret weapon, something we could offer that they couldn't build themselves. I was the commander of the convoy team that was to meet the US soldiers. We were ambushed in Manchester on the way to the rendezvous. There was no way to warn the Americans. They were on their own in York, fighting an enemy they knew nothing about. We never learnt exactly what happened there. All we know is that Nathan Hale was the sole survivor.
Captain, you seeing this?
What the hell is that?
No one knows exactly how Hale was infected by the Chimeran virus. Our only clue is a journal entry recovered from the body of a U.S. medic. It says that he encountered a number of comatose soldiers in a dry creek bed. One of the soldiers, a sergeant, suddenly woke up. Unlike the other soldiers, his body had no wounds at all. The sergeant refused any kind of medical examination, insisting on catching up to the rest of the company. If that sergeant was in fact Nathan Hale, then he remains the only known person to wake up after being infected. Whether the Chimeran virus mutated within him, or whether his body had an innate resistance to it, remains a mystery.
Hey, Sarge, you all right? They told me Arrow 2 was wiped out. Where the hell are the Brits?
Watch it!
Attention, sound off! Baker 1, this is 3. We're moving wounded. It's slow going. Baker 12, we've got what's left of 5 and 10. Approaching depot from Romeo Road, ETA 10 minutes. God damn it, someone's gotta be around here. Where's Arrow? Arrow came in over the AA. They bought in the street. Perfect. All right, all Baker units proceed to the depot ASAP.
Americans regrouped at an abandoned bus depot in southeast York. Under the command of a Captain Winters, they staged a daring tactical offensive. The Chimera had begun to close in on their position. If the Americans could secure the site, they would have a perfect landing zone and the battle would tip in their favor.
This is a prime landing zone. If we can hold it, we'll get some reinforcements of our own in here.
Yes, sir.
Yes, and our machine guns are tearing us to shreds. Get out of that situation. Sir, yes, sir.
Thank you.
We might just hold this little piece of heaven. Tapazzini, bring those tanks in here and scrape out a landing zone.
Sir!
Incoming!
We know from the craters that the Chimera ended the battle by launching spires. There is no defense against a spire attack. By the time you see them in the air, it's already too late. After impact, the spires release swarms of crawlers. Literally thousands of them can come from a single spire. Whole cities have been infected in minutes. After the crawlers have done their work, the Chimera send in carriers to collect the dormant victims. The role of the carriers is to transport infected humans to conversion centers. It's at these locations that the Chimeran creatures are born. Hale was brought to a conversion center in the town of Grimsby. My convoy team and I were imprisoned at the same location. We had been captured uninfected, so we were put in makeshift pens until they could infect us.